Jerry is my nickname.
Well, Jerry, so tell us a little bit about yourself. You're in what part of Vietnam did you say you're from?
I'm from Bình Định province of Vietnam, and I'm just graduated from university, and I am looking for work.
What was your field of study at the university?
My major is economics.
Economy. Great. Well, this is a good
Yeah.
way to find a job, Jerry,
Yeah.
on the internet.
Yeah.
Jerry, just
Yeah.
yesterday I interviewed a delegate to our Democratic National Convention. He's a Vietnamese American,
Okay.
and it will be his first convention, and he's so excited to go.
Yeah.
What did is he a political? What does he do? How did he become a
He has
delegate?
a completely different job, but he quit his job to volunteer for the Obama organization. And
Oh,
so now he's a delegate to go to our national convention, which will be in 2 weeks.
yeah, it's a good opportunity to point out that Carolyn Presutti
Yes.
will be covering the Democratic National Convention first week of September in Charlotte,
Along with Jim Malone
along with Jim Malone,
from
our
Voice of
political
America. Yeah.
correspondent. It's the convention where the parties nominate their candidates and
Right.
officially nominate them. I think we know
Right. It's a
the
given this
candidate.
year.
Right,
So
we know who it's going to be,
it's been
and
questionable in years past. It's always been suspense-filled conventions, but not anymore. Not the modern conventions. And the Republican convention is in 2 weeks, and the Democratic convention is in 3 weeks. So we will, of course, be covering the Republican convention too.
The Republicans are going to be meeting in Tampa, Florida.
Right.
And
Right. And the
all right,
Democrats in
so
Charlotte. So Jerry, are you following American politics?
Yes, I'm really obsessed.
Any thoughts about the election?
Can you tell me I can call in on Skype usually?
Well, we'd like to do these more often because these shows have been very popular. But right now we don't really have a schedule. It's more Carolyn's very busy out covering stories, and I work in special English, and so we do this when we have time. But we would like to do this more regularly because it is very
Yeah.
popular.
And typically we do it Thursdays or Fridays,
Thursdays or Fridays
right?
usually
We try
work
to do
out.
toward the
Yeah.
end of the week. So
Really, I really want to talk on Skype with you as usually. But it is the first time I'm calling because I just dropped to Facebook and I see
Oh,
your
that's fine.
notice, and I quickly come to
Good.
my Skype and call for you, and
We'll always post it.
it's great to
Yeah.
talk to you. So Jerry, we're going to
Yeah.
actually go on to another caller right now.
Bye,
We've
Jerry.
bye,
Good talking to
Jerry.
you.
Mai, can you hear us? Hello?
Hi, Mai.
Are you there? Oh,
She's
can
very
you
low volume.
speak up a little bit? Speak a little louder. We're having trouble hearing you. Well, we can sort of barely hear you, but tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you from?
It's very low. We can hear your voice, but it's very soft. If you could speak louder, that would be great. And May, where are you from? Where are you calling us from? It's very hard to hear
Oh,
her. Maybe she's far from the microphone.
no.
Yeah.
Oh, they are a little better, a little better. Okay, what? Well, what country are you from? Did you mention we heard?
Cambodia.
Cambodia.
Okay.
What part of
Yeah.
Cambodia are you calling from? Oh, yes. All right.
And which part of Cambodia is that? Is that north, south, east, west?
What part of the country?
We aren't hearing
well,
you very well.
It's
you
our.
You know, city. You know, Cambodia city.
Cambodia city.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's near there.
Yeah. First, I live near province, but I continue my study and.
Great.
Well, Maya, it's been great talking to you, and thanks again. We'll talk to you again soon. We're going to Alessio.
Hi, Alessio.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine, thanks. And you?
We're doing well. We're doing great. Where are you from?
It's gorgeous. It's impossible that I'm speaking with you right now. But are you speaking from America?
Yes.
We're here
yes.
in Washington.
And where are you speaking from?
Yes, I come from Italy.
Italy? Where in Italy?
Yes. Nothing. I read your message on Facebook.
Yes.
And for this, I decided to add you on my Skype.
Great, Alessio. Where are you from in Italy? What city?
Yes.
What city in Italy?
Ferrara.
Ferrara. Oh. You make excellent
it's
cookies.
The chocolate too.
Yes, it's located in the north part of Italy, but
right.
I come from the south part of Italy, Taranto.
Taranto.
I am right now in the north part of Italy because I'm studying at university.
Mm-hmm.
I am a student.
What is your field? What are you studying?
I'm studying to become a nurse.
A nurse, excellent.
There is a nursing shortage in the United
right.
States. We in recent years we've been hearing about a shortage of nurses, and there have been campaigns to try to increase the number of nurses. And nurses here are getting more responsibilities. And
right.
and
yes.
what kind of nursing is there a specialty you want to that you're focusing on or.
Right now, it's the second year that I'm studying as nurse. I will be graduated the next year, and I hope to transfer in the United Kingdom or in Australia to work as nurse. And for this, I'm studying in English, and I'm trying to improve it.
You do very well.
Your
English is
excellent. Actually, you know, we have the special English weekly program called The Health Report, and if you're interested in finding, you know, stories for use in medical English, I would, you know, go to voaspecialenglish.com
right.
and search for The Health Report, and
yes.
and you'll find stories that you may learn some information from it, although
yes.
you probably got, well, we've got five callers all waiting in line here, but Alessio, good luck with
ciao,
your studies.
Ciao, Alessio.
We're going to
thank
go,
you very much.
Take care. Bye.
Ciao.
Ashraf,
are you there?
Are you there, Ashraf?
No.
Ashraf?
How about? Oh, there we are.
Oh, can you
hi,
hear us?
Ashraf.
Not so great. Okay, we're going to, let's see this. We're going to go to this caller here. Hello, you're on the line. Hello? Can you hear us? Okay, we're going to go to someone named Abstract.
Hello,
Abstract. We never heard that name before.
Tell me how you can help me.
Sure. Tell us what you need.
I want to know. Why should I call you?
Well, we're discussing English, learning English, and we're also discussing the national conventions. Which would you like to talk about?
You said what to call us? Well, this is Carolyn, and I'm Avi.
I'm okay. That's good. I'm a learner of English. That's why I call.
Great.
And I'm talking from Pakistan. I'm calling from Pakistan.
Very good.
And tell me what I can learn. Tell me something. I mean, tell me the thing which I can endure right now.
This is the best. This is the best way to learn is to converse,
okay.
talk with someone who is an English speaker or native English speaker. Which
exactly.
Abby and I
yeah.
are.
Yeah, I mean, this is for conversation, you know, there's it's hard to find a substitute for,
right.
you know, conversational practice and with someone who you can, you know, you can practice this with the internet.
Yeah. Exactly,
yeah.
And especially from the country which is, I mean, which have very down, very low literacy rate, and here you can hardly find a person speaking English. So.
Yeah.
It means I'm fond of learning English. So tell me what I can learn.
Good. If you listen to our broadcast, sure, you can, right online. It's so different than it used to be. I mean, imagine your parents growing up and not having the internet.
Yeah, right, exactly. I said this to someone yesterday in the office. I said, can you remember the, you know, the pre-Google age,
right,
or the pre-Yahoo
right.
age, where, I mean, we needed to know an obscure piece of information yesterday. I found it within, you know, half a second.
Right.
And now, you're right, not everyone obviously
right.
has the internet. But so when you go online, do you have internet or do you go to an internet cafe? How do you go online?
Okay. When it comes to speak, I feel that I am losing my power to express what I am actually feeling. But when it comes to writing, and I fully express what I am feeling. Can you tell how can I improve my speaking, giving words to my thoughts? How can I improve this? And second, how can I improve my grammar? I mean, have a strong grip on it.
I think that's totally natural to be afraid to speak, because your audio is very different. Your mind has to play into everything you're saying, what's coming out of your mouth. And when you're writing, you can think about it as you're writing, you can erase it. But when you're talking, it's much more difficult. And that's why you definitely gather more speed when you talk, and you also gather more confidence when you talk with someone.
I'm sorry, I'm interrupting.
Let me share
one thing.
Sure.
You know, when you speak, I'm talking, I don't know your name.
Carolyn.
You speak, I mean female. When you speak, I can easily understand. But when a male with you, I mean a guy with you speaking, I feel problem in understanding you. Why
you're
is
just,
that?
You're just a ladies' man, that's all.
Yeah, that's right. Well, Carolyn does a lot. You know, Carolyn's job is she goes on television and reads the news every day. This is her specialty.
But it could also be just because you listen to a higher tone, because I obviously have a higher voice than Avi.
Exactly. That's the real point.
It may be just that your ear likes the higher tone better than a lower tone.
Maybe I'm not an active listener. Maybe.
You're doing great.
When you earlier said sorry to interrupt, I thought that's something I've been trying to teach myself, rather than cutting someone off.
Yeah.
It's what you said. What do they call that? Like a discourse? No, it's not a discourse marker. There's a name that's a part of active learning. What you did, or active listening. It's saying things like I'm sorry for interrupting, or let me see if I let me make sure I understood what you just said. These are all little strategies that work
right.
for native speakers and for learners. In a conversation, I'm sure when you're doing an interview. When we do interviews, you know, you don't want to talk over the person, so you wait for them to. There's a natural break, or you say, let me jump in with a question here. Conversational
Absolutely.
Strategies.
I think it's very good that you're doing that. Now, we want to get to one thing quickly before we hang up with
yeah.
you, and that's grammar. He asked about grammar, right?
Well,
May I know how old are you people?
No, that's all right.
You can Google that.
Yeah, you can Google it. Yeah, that'll be your. I think the thing with the grammar is basically reading. Good
right.
quality materials, good, you know, books, magazine articles, anything you can find. Okay, we've gone on. We've got.
Do we have on the line?
Nuridaya on the line. Hello.
Can you hear us?
Can you hear us?
Hello.
Hello. Okay, we're going to go to Abdo. Abdo.
Abdo, are you there?
Hello,
oh,
Abdo.
Oh, I hear somebody.
I hear someone, yes.
Abdo?
Abdo.
No. How about Samir?
Okay, we're going to go to Samir.
Hi, Samir.
Hi, Samir. How are you doing?
Hello. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Good.
What's new?
Yeah, I'm fine. Your topic is about or what?
Samir, you're breaking up a bit. We're not hearing you real well. I think
okay
the connection.
Then.
Oh, there you are. A little better. Can you hear
okay.
us?
Okay.
Yeah.
Sure. Go
better.
Ahead and talk.
Yeah, you hear me?
Yes.
Now, great. Yes.
What's your question or comment? Hello. Yeah, okay. We're going to try calling back a caller we had on hold here. Whoops. Okay, let's see if we can get
it. The computer gets that hourglass, and we always worry when we see the hourglass.
That's right. It's not good. See the hourglass. Let's see if we can get this guy off hold. All right.
Oh, there we go.
Let's try calling him.
And his name is?
Ashraf. Let's see if we can get a hold of him here.
Ashraf, answer your Skype if you're watching us.
That's right. It's Abby and Carolyn calling.
Yes.
Well, we've got all these people sending us.
Got a lot of people on the line today.
Oh, hello.
Thank you. Ashraf, are you there?
Hi.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm with you.
And where do you live, Ashraf?
About this time.
Where? Say a little louder, please. Where do you live?
Palestine.
Which part? West Bank, Gaza?
Gaza.
Excellent.
Good to hear from you. What what's on your mind?
What do you do there?
What do you do? Are you a student?
Yeah, I'm.
You're going to need to speak a little louder. We can't really hear you. Can you speak a little louder, Ashraf?
Yeah.
That's better.
I am a programmer.
Programmer.
I was just reading about, there was an article in the New York Times about the growing industry, the information technology and programming industry in the West Bank and Gaza. I'm trying to remember what part, but it was very interesting. So you do you work for a local company or an international company?
Private company, and I am just a beginner.
A beginner.
Not that proficient.
Not proficient. What kind of programming do you do?
Database and Delphi, if you hear about it, Delphi programming language, Delphi.
Okay, and what is that used for? Tell us a little bit about that programming language.
Mostly desktop applications.
In which applications?
A little louder, please. We're because I'm gonna turn the speaker up a little bit here. So if you could tell us a little again about the language, because we're having trouble hearing you a little bit.
I can't hear.
Okay. Well, Ashraf, we're gonna go to.
Great talking to you.
Nice talking to you, and good luck with your programming work. Hello, Yasser. Oops. Let's see here. Yasser, can you hear us? Who is that on? We're hearing. Let's try to clear. Oh, wait.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Who's that? Yasser?
Hello, good afternoon.
Hello, Yasser?
Yeah.
Yes,
hi,
great
Yasser.
To hear from
where,
you.
Where are you calling from?
Hello.
Hi.
Where do you live, Yasser?
I live in Algeria.
Algeria. Excellent.
Yeah.
And what do you do in Algeria?
Hmm? I'm a student. I study there.
What are you studying?
Hydrocarbon.
Hydrocarbon?
Yeah.
So oil and gas, petroleum industry.
What?
When you say hydrocarbon, are you talking about petroleum industry or?
Sorry, I just learned this language.
Good.
my level is. Is low in this English. In English, I is low.
This is the best way to learn.
I'm trying to learn.
You're doing well. This is the best way to learn.
Yeah,
is to speak.
Just to have a chance to chat for a minute or two. Now within the English is of course it's the language of the oil industry.
I am a level two in this language. I'm a level two. I'm going to level three.
Level three. Oh, good. Good for you. So,
when did you start?
In private school in Wargla. Her name is Hass School.
And you've been studying for a year or a month? How long?
Two months.
I
do one level in 2 months.
Wow.
Excellent.
One level for 2 months, yeah.
Do you prefer to speak or write English?
to speak and write. To speak and write, yeah.
Uh-huh. Which one do you like better?
to speak.
To speak.
Yeah, that's more fun. Yeah. That's more fun.
But yet the other caller told us it's easier to write.
That's true. That's true. That's all right. That some people prefer to.
I want to improve my vocabulary.
Well, that's a big word in itself. Vocabulary. That's good.
Are you using our programs, the VOA Special English programs, the Learning English programs we do? Do you know about the voaspecialenglish.com? It's reading and listening comprehension materials that can help you improve. But Yasser, it's been great talking to you, and
Bye, we're
going to go on now to Abdo.
Abdo.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello, Abdo.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, we're fine. Hey. How are you doing?
Oh, fine.
Where are you, Abdul? It sounds like you're in a tunnel.
No, we hear a little bit of an echo.
What?
Where do you live?
I am from Syria, but I live in Saudi Arabia, KSA. Okay.
South Arabia.
He's living in Saudi Arabia.
Saudi Arabia, yes. And what do you do there?
What kind of job do you do there?
I am a student in high school.
High school, great.
Yes.
No school today, or what time is it?
No, we don't have school. This is the summer vacation.
When do you return?
What?
When do you return to school? What day?
In 9 maybe. After 1 month.
1 month.
How many, what year of high school are you?
What? Can you repeat, please?
Are you a senior, junior, sophomore? What year?
I didn't understand what you say.
Well, maybe grade 10th
what
grade?
What grade are you in? Grade? Are you in the 10th?
It's 9th.
9th grade.
Oh, so you're
very young.
That in the U.S., 9th grade is the first year of high school. So you're like 14 or 15 years old?
14.
You sound much older.
Yes, you do. So what did you do this summer? How do you have fun?
I have many hopes, like basketball, swimming, and I have a social relationships.
Social friendships.
So were you watching the Olympics? Were you watching the basketball and the swimming? And
yes.
What did you?
The Mundial and the European Championship. Champion.
Who's your favorite basketball player? Just out of curiosity, who's?
I don't have, but I have a football striker. Messi.
That's your favorite player, Messi?
Yes, yes.
Who's he play for? Sorry, I'm not familiar with him. What team?
Sorry to admit, we don't. Who is that?
Argentina. He play in Barcelona.
The best then.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Great. Great talking to you. Keep up the good work.
We are going to go on to good luck in your high school career now.
Impressive for a 14-year-old. Yeah, very nice.
Hello, Liha. Can you?
Hi, Liha.
Are you there?
Nope.
Okay, we're going to go to Hong. Hong, are you there?
Hi.
Hi.
Yes.
Welcome to our show. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Hong, where are you? Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Sydney.
Sydney, Australia?
Yes.
Very good. What do you do there?
I'm studying. I'm just an overseas student.
Did you say university student?
Yes. I didn't say that, but actually I am, yeah.
And what do you study?
I'm studying nursing.
Nursing, another nurse.
Did you hear the earlier caller who is studying to be a nurse? We had another caller a little while ago. I forget where he was from, but he was also studying to become a nurse.
Uh-huh.
So that's
sorry. Yeah. Well, what is your name? Sorry.
This is I'm Avi, and this
I'm
is Carolyn.
Carolyn. Okay, Carolyn and Avi.
Yes.
Right. All right. Nice to meet. Nice to talk to you.
Nice.
To you guys.
Nice.
Now, how did you end up in Australia? You don't sound Australian with the accent.
Are you an international
No, I'm
student?
Vietnamese.
Vietnamese.
I'm Vietnamese.
Yes.
Yeah.
And why Australia?
I'm Vietnamese, but I came here. Yeah. I have been here for about 2 years and a half.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
It's interesting that we have a story today that's going to be going up on our website in a little while, this week's Education Report in Special English. And we actually look at this issue of international students and the problems they sometimes have making friends. Now, the story was with people from the country where they're studying. We looked at the United States, but we also talked about Australia because I guess there's some issues. Problems. A lot of international students say they don't feel very welcome, or that they have trouble they feel lonely. Some feel discriminated against. I know the Australian government, created a council to come up with a 5-year plan to sort of give to improve, strengthen the international education industry in Australia. I mean, have you felt welcomed in Australia?
Actually, is it the area I'm living at, or at the
right.
University I'm doing my course.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah, a lot of them are overseas students, and a lot of them come from China,
mm-hmm.
from Vietnam, from Indochina, or other country as well, like India or Mexico, something like that.
So you don't feel any discrimination.
Do you feel, Australian
sometimes,
friends?
But it's very rarely, it's very rare. And the other thing is, sometimes for me, I'm not very confident to communicate with Aussie people because your English is not very, my English is not very good. Mm-hmm. And the other thing is, sometimes they speak very fast and then you don't understand what they're talking about, so sometimes when you ask you question or something like that, or they tell you their story and you don't really understand what they're talking
right.
about,
and they do have that accent that's very different from the English
language. I feel like American accent is much more make me, for myself, I think it's a bit easier to understand than.
Now, I'm very curious, though. Why did you choose an Australian school?
At that time, I think the thing is, my mom and my dad, income is few Australian, tuition fee. Australian
mm-hmm.
tuition fee is a bit cheaper than England, England
mm-hmm.
or American, I think.
Australia has a very big international education industry, a business. I mean, so does the United States and Britain.
Education is the third biggest industry in Australia, that's why.
What are the two biggest industries, if you know?
The first is mining.
Oh,
the
mining.
Second one is something else, and then education is
and
the
education.
Third one, I think.
Huh.
I mean, the income, the the GDP come from the education, from international students,
Han, you say you're very reticent. I don't know if you know what that word means, but you hesitate to speak to the Australians. Your English is very good.
I agree.
You should be confident. You're very good at English. Go out there and talk to more people today.
You bet me,
Thanks, Han.
Yes, calling, VOA.
Well,
I used to learn English from VOA website since I was in Vietnam for,
Great.
I think 3 or 4 years ago, when because I studied French. I had been studying French for 7 years in Vietnam. At that time, when my roommates learned English, and then
mm-hmm.
I have heard about this VOA websites from my friend, because Yeah, that's time
right.
I had no idea about this.
Our programs are very popular in Vietnam,
yes.
Used extensively in schools, so we're very happy
yes.
about that.
Thanks, Sung.
Can,
keep up the good work in Australia.
All right, well, nice talking
okay.
to you. We are going to take...
take care.
See if we can... Hi.
Liha. Liha, are you there?
Can you hear us?
Hello,
Liha.
Yes.
Thanks for calling back. I saw that you called before, and then you called back.
Yeah, I'm here.
Right?
Hi, where...
Can you hear me?
Yes.
We can hear you. Where are you calling from?
Where do you live, Liha?
Yeah.
Oops. Oh.
Where do you
yeah,
live?
Yeah, I'm from Vietnam.
Vietnam.
Hello?
Yes. We just spoke to someone.
Yeah, Vietnam.
We spoke to someone who's from Vietnam but studying in Australia.
Is studying nursing.
Oh, really?
In Australia.
Right. Have you lived there all your life in Vietnam? Liha?
Sorry?
You there?
Me?
Did you grow
yeah,
up?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Did you grow up in Vietnam? Maybe so. Tell us what you do in Vietnam, Liha.
Sorry, I can't hear you very good.
Okay.
I'm a fresh graduate.
Oh, she just graduated.
No, I'm a fresh graduate in Vietnam.
First
grader. Okay, I'm sorry. We're having problems with that call. Hello. Hi. Who's this?
Hi, how are you?
Fine, thanks. Where are you calling from?
I'm from Jordan.
Jordan.
And what's your name?
My name is Maud.
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 Yeah. I'm Avi, and this is Carolyn.
Hi,
and
Maud.
And welcome to our show.
Hi.
What do you do in Jordan?
I live there.
Do you have a job, or are you a student? Or?
Yeah, I'm at postgraduate level. I'm still searching for a job.
And what is your field of study, or what field did you graduate in?
A communication engineer.
Oh, excellent. What type of job do you want?
Something related with what I studied, you know, like networking or something like that, internet service provider.
How hard is it to find a job in Jordan these days?
Oh, it's really hard.
Very hard. Did you see
yeah.
it getting any better, or is it just going downhill?
No, it's still the same.
How long have you been out of school?
I graduated before 4 months, something about.
4 months.
Yeah.
Do you go to interviews to get your jobs, or do you apply online? Do you apply with email?
Yeah, I apply online, and I had some interviews, you know, but they didn't hire me.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's do.
Part, you have to know someone in the company,
yes.
You know.
In one line, tell us why we should hire you.
That's right.
Tell
this
everybody.
Is this is called the if you've ever heard the term elevator speech, 30-second elevator speech. It's if you were in an elevator with someone and you had 30 seconds to tell them why that person should hire you, what's your elevator speech?
Go ahead. You're on. 30 seconds.
You know, it's hard because I'm a freshly graduated, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know a lot about the practical in this field, you know. I know some theories, something like that. So if they want to hire me, because maybe I can improve myself in the company.
I think you should stress the fact that you just graduated, because you can say, I bring youth and I bring energy
and
to your company.
Fresh knowledge of the field.
And fresh ideas.
The latest knowledge, the latest information. And you wouldn't cost as much as hiring someone more experienced.
Add that to your elevator speech.
Uh-huh.
And let us know when you get a job. Call us back.
We're gonna. It's been great talking to you. We're gonna go on to Irawan. Hello, Irawan.
Hi, Irawan.
Irawan?
Nope.
Oh, no. Okay. We're going to try calling. Here she's calling back. Hello, you're on the line with Avi and Carolyn.
Hello.
I see you've been trying to call for a while, so I'm glad.
Okay.
Yeah. What is your name?
Hello.
What is your name?
Can you hear us?
There's a baby.
Oh, okay.
Hello, I'm sorry, it was a network problem.
Okay.
That's okay.
Hello?
Hi, was that, can you hear us? Hello?
Oh, now we're having... I wish we could talk
okay.
to you. I know she's
We've
been calling.
We've got Elaine calling in.
Elaine from Brazil. Hello.
Hi, can you hear us?
Elaine, are you there?
Hello, Elaine. Hello? Okay. Hello. Hi.
Is that how we pronounce your name?
How do we pronounce your name?
Wael or Waolu?
Can you hear us? Maybe not.
Oh, we're going through a couple of
we're having network problems of our own.
Yes.
Okay, we're back with Nuridaya. Hello, Nuridaya?
I think she's listening to us.
I can hear our voice coming back. Okay, we're going to go to Garmian. Hello, Garmian.
Garmian, are you there?
Hello.
Yeah,
there you are.
Hi.
Hello. I have to ask, there you have a picture of cherries in place of your picture.
Hello. Can you hear us?
Garmian?
Yes, I like.
You like cherries?
Hello.
How are you?
Fine, thanks. How are you?
Hello.
We're here.
Hello.
Can you hear us?
How are you?
We're having some connection problems here. Okay. We're going to try
Nuridaya
one more time.
For the third time.
Back to Nuridaya.
Hi, Nuridaya. Can you hear us now?
Wow. All right. Well, we have gotten a lot of calls.
We did get a lot of calls. This was great today.
Well, listen, why don't we'll do this again very soon. You've got to get back to the newsroom, and I've got a story I've got to edit.
Yes. Thanks, everyone, for
calling.
It's
been great talking to you.
We'll
post another when we're ready to do this again. We'll put it again on Facebook. Wait, we're going to take...
Andre. All right,
we'll go
caller.
Out on one call here. Andre.
Andre, you're our final caller. Are you there, Andre?
Oh.
I see you. Andre, hello.
We see you.
I think he's
We're
still
staring
getting,
at you.
Yeah, he's still getting it. Maybe he doesn't
well, Andre,
have his earpiece in.
Oh, no.
All right. Well, everybody.
All right. Well, listen, thanks for joining us today. We'll do this again soon from VOA Learning English in Washington. I'm Avi.
And I'm Carolyn Presutti. Nice to see you today.
Take care. Bye-bye.